三个礼拜前，我们欢庆耶稣基督从死里复活。
A few weeks ago, we celebrated the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ.
我们知道耶稣复活以后，他四十天，他在这个世界继续的啊好几次的显明给许许多多的人看。
So we know that after his resurrection for 40 days, he spent his time on earth appearing to many.
所以如果回到两千年前
So therefore if we go back to 2000 years ago
今天仍是耶稣基督复活、活在地面上的时候
Meaning this is still a period of time that Jesus was still on earth
耶稣基督复活是基督教会的那个信仰的根基
So the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ is an important foundation of our Christian faith
我们知道耶稣如果没有复活当耶稣被钉死的时候门徒都四处的逃窜
Because we know if Jesus did not resurrect and the disciples then when Jesus was crucified, they fled everywhere.
他们所受到的是那一种毁灭性的绝望
Because that kind of hopelessness was destructive to them.
很多人知道这种毁灭性的绝望是很难恢复的有时候要几年甚至有的一生都没有办法恢复。
Now we know when a person's hope is destroyed, sometimes it takes even years for it to be restored again.
因为他们三年多朝夕相处的门徒，他们的依靠是主耶稣基督。
Because for three odd years they was with the Lord Jesus Christ, they relied on the Lord Jesus.
这时候耶稣基督竟然被钉在十字架上死了。
But yet the Lord Jesus that they loved was crucified on the cross.
那种绝望是真的绝望。
So that dejection was a true dejection.
然而几天之后，忽然间发现这些门徒，非常的这个刚强，非常的活跃。
But yet few days after, they realized the disciples suddenly they were very active, they were very vibrant.
传扬耶稣基督复活了。
And everywhere they preached that Jesus had resurrected.
以致官长要恐吓他们，如果你们再说耶稣复活，我就把你们下到监里。
Such that the councilmen have to warn them if they continue to preach the Lord Jesus Christ's resurrection, they will be in prison.
然而他们不害怕，继续的。到处宣扬，大声宣扬，耶稣基督复活了。
But yet the disciples were not afraid. They declared boldly and loudly, Jesus indeed had risen.
明白事理的人都知道，他们一定发现了一件的事情，使他们在这种毁灭性不可能恢复的情况中，他们勇敢的起来了。
So all men with reason will know there must be a reason.Why these disciples suddenly in their destroyed faith were restored and were alive again?
这件奇异的事，奇怪的事，就是他们看见了复活的主。
So this strange phenomenon is that surely the disciples have seen the risen Lord.
刚才我们读的这段圣经前面说，他说耶稣从死里复活以后，向门这十四节，耶稣从死里复活以后向门徒显现。这是第三次。
And in verse 14, in the scripture we read earlier, it says, this was not the first time, the third time, Jesus appeared to his disciples after he was raised from the dead.
但是如果我们从约翰的记录，耶稣复活到现在呢，其实不止三次了，很多次了。
But we know that not just these three times, it was many times that the Lord had appeared to many.
弟兄姐妹，复活不是人类的经验，我们没有复活的经验。
Now today, we have never experienced what is resurrection.
很多人说耶稣死，拉撒路复活。
Some people say that Jesus have raised Lazarus from the dead.
使南城的这个寡妇的儿子复活。
That the widow's son in Nain City was raised from the dead.
在旧约也有这个以利亚、以利沙死人复活的这样的一个事实、一个记录。
And also the Old Testament, whether it's Elijah, they have raised the people from dead.
那是复活吗
？But is that true resurrection?
圣经老师说那不是复活，那是还魂。
The Bible teachers say that is not resurrection, that is the soul returning to the body.
复活的意思就是复活以后呢，他就永远不再死了。
Because resurrection is true meaning is that when he lives again, he will never die.
拉撒路复活之后，拉撒路又死了。
Because Lazarus was raised from the dead, he will surely die.
南城寡妇的孩子复活之后，他也死了。
And the city of Nain, the widow's son, when he was raised from the dead, he still died.
唯耶稣基督复活之后， 而且活到永永远远。
Only Jesus Christ was raised from the dead and he lived on forever.
所以复活的事很难通过人的头脑。
So therefore, this resurrection is something we reasonable minds cannot reason.
理性主义者绝对不相信有复活的事。
And people who want to live only by reason, they cannot accept these things.
但是复活却是理性。对我们来说是理性的事。
But yet this is something which is also to us Christians very reasonable.
为什么呢？
Why is that so?
因为我们相信有一位神。
Because we believe there is God.
我们来到这里的每一个人都相信有一位又真又活的神。
Every person who has come here all believe there is a true and living God.
他称为耶和华。
He is the Lord.
耶和华是什么意思？
What does the Lord mean?
耶和华的意思就是他无所不知、无所不能、无所不在。
That meaning he is all powerful, he is all present, he is all knowing.
既然我们相信这位神，
Since we believe such a God.
我们相信他创造天地。
We believe he created the heavens
and earth. 六天创造天地。
In 6 days he created all creation.
这位满有全能的神。
And this great and almighty God.
他使耶稣从死里复活，有什么难？
He is the same God who raised Jesus from the dead. So what else can he not do?
我们既相信这位神。
So we believe in such a great God.
我们看到圣经里面所讲的神迹。那完全是可信的。
And all the miracles that we have read in the Bible, those are believable.
请注意请注意我说的，在圣经里面所有的神迹，那完全是可信的。
So please take note, all the miracles recorded in the Bible, they are all believable.
还有耶稣是生命的主。
And also Jesus is the Lord of life.
生命的主死了。才是奇迹。
Now the Lord of Life, if he dies, then this itself is something amazing.
生命的主怎么会死呢？
Because how can the Lord of Life ever die?
他是为了拯救世人。
But you know why? Because for the sake of the salvation of men.
他说我的命是我自己放弃的。
Jesus says, I give up my life.
我自己放弃，我可以自己的取回。
If I lay down my life, I will take it back again.
所以他是生命之主。
Therefore, he is truly the Lord of Life.
有什么困难？
To be risen from the dead, is that not he can do?
感谢上帝。
So we thank and praise God.
我们信的是一位又真又活的主。
The Lord we believe is a true and living God.
他复活了。
He really has risen.
当时很多人看见他。
And many people at that time saw him.
有人要用说这或者是因为太思念他。而看到了幻象。
So some cynics have said that maybe these people were deceived because they missed him so much.
这种可能性就是这一个人，可能是这一个人或者几个人。
So it could be one person, it could also be many persons.
有时候当你看到这个人的时候，而你没有看到。
Just like sometimes we see a person, but the other person may not see.
为什么呢？
And why is that so?
有人说这种人是阴阳眼。
So some people say that these people have yin yang, 阴阳
eyes. 他可以看到一个死人活人走向他。
So they say that some people have this yin yang eye who can see people from the dead.
这样的经历你信吗？
But do you believe such people then?
我相信。
Now I believe.
但这是什么原因啊？
But for what reason?
这是他的脑神经的，这个是脑神经的作用。
I believe he truly see because.It is a mental illness.
他绝对不是看到那个人复活。
He did not really see a person resurrected.
所以我们看到耶稣看到的，他门徒看到耶稣复活，绝对不是个幻象。
But we know that what the disciples truly have seen are not just illusory.
使徒保罗得到启示。
Now, when the Apostle Paul received revelation,
很多方面，他关于复活的事，他得到了启示。
Many times about revelation, about resurrection, he received these revelations.
耶稣讲，生命在我，复活在我，信我的人。虽然死了也必复活。
The Lord Jesus once declared, I am the life and the resurrection. He who believes in me will live even though he dies.
可是耶稣没有讲到什么时候我们复活。
But Jesus had never said, when will we resurrect?
我们复活的身体是怎么样的？
And how will bodies actually be like when we resurrect?
耶稣什么都没有说。
Jesus himself did not say these things.
感谢上帝。
But we thank God.
当耶稣升天之后，差遣圣灵下来。
Now when the Lord Jesus resurrected and sent the Spirit to this world,
圣灵下来有一个目的。
Now there is a purpose of the Spirit in the world.
他要使他的教会的人 说方言说语言
and he will cause his church to see visions and to make dreams
然后看异象做一梦 and they 说方言说语言
they will speak in tongues they will speak in words of revelation
所以这些方言预言异象异梦是指着什么呢
so all these prophecies words of revelation What do they mean?
是指做特殊启示.
All this refer to a special revelation.
圣灵来了帮助教会领受特殊启示.
Meaning the Spirit has come to the world, to the church, to help them to receive revelation.
然后在那第四季.
And then in the first century,
真的这些门徒这些使徒,
and truly these disciples and all these apostles,
他们就从预言、异象、方言、预言当中领受了启示.
It's from tongues, from visions, from dreams, from revelation. They received this from God.
写了许多的作品,
and they made many writings.
包括新约的27卷都在。 第四季写完了
and even the 27 books in the New Testament among the writings have been written
但是还没有编辑成书
but yet at that time they were not canonized
那时候不止27卷啊
so among the writings not just 27 books
还有很多很多的书
but many other books the apostles have written
有的说还有什么多马福音
some people say there is a gospel of Thomas
还有其他的书卷
and many other books written by the apostles
一直到大概第四世纪吧
All the way until the 4th century.
教会开大会,
when the church had a council.
然后他们从这些书卷当中,
and then all the writings that they have found among the apostles.
圣灵的帮助,
and through the help of the Spirit.
定下了27卷,
they canonized only 27 writings.
成为新约正典,
to become the books of the Canon of the New Testament.
正典是什么意思呢?
What does the Canon mean?
就是它绝对有权威,
meaning it has absolute authority.
刚才我们在读我们的告白信仰告白的时候,
Earlier when we read our Zion Church Confession of Faith,
it,
for example, it says, I believe in the Bible.
是上帝启示的,
it is revealed by God.
然后没有错误,
it is inerrant.
是我们生活, 跟信仰的最高准则,
it is the supreme standard of faith and the conduct of life of all mankind.
什么意思啊?
What does this mean?
生活有问题了,
meaning when our life has problems,
信仰有问题了,
when our faith meets problems,
我们回到新旧约的正典,
we go back to the supreme authority, which is the Bible of the Old and New Testament.
然后我们就得到了答案,
then through this authority, we find answers.
那个答案就是绝对的了,
these answers are absolute.
感谢上帝,
so we thank and praise God.
耶稣没有讲,
Even though Jesus did not talk about resurrection,
但是,
what else?
保罗就说了,
so Paul said,
第一,有许多人看到,
so Paul revealed by saying, many people have seen him.
彼得看到,
Peter has seen him.
十二使徒看到,
the apostles have seen
还有呢,
him. And
主的弟兄雅各看到,
even his brother James have seen him.
还有呢,
and
一时有500多人看到耶稣基督的复活.
At that time, there are 500 disciples who have seen the resurrected Jesus.
保罗在写更多前书的时候呢, 还说还有一半的人还在地面上。
And Paul, when he was writing 1 Corinthians chapter 15, he said, upon writing, there were still half which are still alive.
所以保罗说他神 亲自的也让他，耶稣亲自也让他看到。
And Paul himself also revealed that Jesus Christ appeared to him as well.
这是非常有力的见证人。
So therefore, these are reliable witnesses.
复活的事。
So the things of the resurrection.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们,
dear brethren,
我不知道你今天仍然怀疑,
I do not know whether you have any disbelief or doubts, or you have half beliefs.
或者说人问你, 耶稣真的复活吗?
Or you may ask, did Jesus resurrect?
不知道我们的牧师是这么说的。
Now, you, when people ask you, you may say, no, my pastor told me, so this is how I believe.
这样的信仰是败坏的信仰啊。
Now, if you have such a faith, this is wicked.
我们恳求主怜悯我们,
May the Lord help us.
绝对相信我们的主复活了,
we must absolutely believe that Jesus has resurrected.
我们今天非常有能力地活在地面上,
because only because Jesus resurrected, then we have strength to live on.
我们一点也不害怕,
and we have no fears in life.
当日主耶稣, 当日的门徒, 灰心丧志的时候,
so on those days when the disciples were dejected and hopeless.
在刚才我们读的圣经的前半部,
now in the first former verse of the what we have read,
他们还有些已经到处去了，心散了,
and they were all fled and they have all been dispersed.
但是有七个门徒还在一起,
But there were some disciples that were still with them.
他们回到他们老家，重操旧业，重新去捕鱼。
They have gone back to the hometown, old profession, fishing.
当时作为领袖的西门说，我打鱼去。
At that time, it seems the chief of these apostles, Peter, says, "I'm going out to fish."
他们说，我们也和你同去。
And these people say, "Let us go with you."
他们就去打鱼了。
And they went out to fish.
可是那夜打不着什么。
But the evening they caught nothing.
忽然间听见岸边有声音。
And then suddenly at the shore they heard.
起先不知道是谁。
At first they do not know who that person is.
后来发现是主耶稣。
And they realized it was Jesus.
主耶稣当时向他们显现。
And then Jesus appeared to them at that time.
告诉他们把网撒在船的右边。
And told them, throw your net on the right side of the boat.
那夜本来打不着什么。
They could not find anything then.
主耶稣看见他们没有责备，为什么你们再回去打鱼啊。
And Jesus in the first place didn't rebuke them. Why do you go back to fish?
反而是问小子，你们有吃的没有？
But instead ask them, have you any to eat?
他们回答没有。
And when they answered no,
何等绝望的回答。
And then they answered dejectedly,
何等这个可怜的回答。
And very pitifully, pathetically, they answered that. 感谢上帝
耶稣的带领。
And we thank God,by the leading of Jesus,
他们抓了153条的大鱼。
They have 153 fish that were caught.
从零到153。
From nothing to 153.
倍数多少呢？
So how many times more?
我们知道，我们读过数学都明白。
Now simple maths we know.
从零到153的倍数是无穷。
Now it is infinite through that.
所以这表示在神的带领之下。
So it means when the Lord leads.
神的恩典是无穷无尽的。要赐给他的每一个儿女。
It is God's grace, infinite, bountiful grace that will give to every of His children.
以后耶稣为他们预备早餐。
And then the Lord Jesus prepared breakfast for them.
他们吃了早餐以后，耶稣就对西门彼得说：“刚才我们已经读到了。
”So we read this passage. When they finished eating, Jesus said to Simon Peter,
约翰的儿子西门，你爱我比这些更深吗
？”So Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，当我们已经很多时候。读过这段圣经。
And dear brethren, we have read this verse so many times.
我们听过这段圣经。
We have heard so many times the teaching of this passage.
今天最少有几十位的牧师传道在这里。
Here there are at least scores of pastors among us.
不单我们几位牧师。
Not just a few of us here.
还有二十多位的牧师传道在这里。
There were 20 odd pastors, preachers also here.
我相信他们也讲过这段圣经。
I believe they too must have preached this passage before.
当然圣经像双刃的利剑。
But we know that the Bible is a double-edged sword.
我们用正确的解经方法。
We use the right principles of interpreting the Bible.
其实圣经可以很多面来看它带出来的教导。
And in many ways, we can see the teachings and applications of the interpretation.
很多人讲这段圣经的时候是回到原文。
Some people say, when you want to study the Bible, go back to the original text.
耶稣三次问彼得，你爱我吗？
And thrice, Jesus asked Peter, do you love me?
他们说，他这个爱呀。就有希腊文的那种不同层次的爱。
And the original text has shown different forms of love in Greek.
但是今天我们不讲这些。
But we're not going to talk about that.
因为很多时候我们听过了。
Because we've heard all these teachings before.
但是你爱我比这些更深吗？
But we're going to learn when Jesus says, do you love me more than these?
这些话是我们侍奉主的那个动力。
These words are the dynamic of how we serve.
当我们软弱了。
Because when we are weak,
我们去打球。
We go and play football.
礼拜天朋友告诉我们。
On Sundays, our friends said to us,
我们去操练身体。
Let us go to the gym.
所以很多人在礼拜天没有来。
So there's some people on Sundays, they don't come to church.
但我们侍奉的动力是什么呢？
So what is the dynamic of why we serve?
耶稣问彼得，你爱我比这些更深吗？
So Jesus asked Peter, do you love me more than these?
当我们这时候在球场的时候。
Now when we are now in a field.
当我们这时候在海边练气功的时候。
Now when we are at a shore learning
tai chi. 当我们这时候在咖啡店跟朋友聊天吃早餐的时候。
When on Sundays we are having breakfast in a coffee shop.
就在这个时候。
At this time,
你听到了主说你爱我比这些更深吗？
You may have heard Jesus saying to you, do you love me more than these?
或者我们问，
And then we may even ask ourselves,
我爱这些，
do I love these?
比主更深吗？
More than the Lord.
那么大 案当然，答案当然你懂了。
Of course, we know the answer.
彼得当时怎么说
？And how did Peter answer?
你爱主啊，是的，你知道我爱你。
And Peter answered, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you."
耶稣三次问彼得
，and Jesus asked Peter three times.
彼得不知道，主啊，你知道我爱你。
And Peter's answer was, "Lord, you know I love you."
弟兄姐妹，当这个时候我正在跟人喝咖啡聊天的时候
，So at this time, if I were having coffee, eating breakfast on Sundays with friends,
这个是礼拜天早晨，我们常常在新加坡的这个生活常常是这样的。
So this is what we do in Singapore in a coffee shop, having meal with our friends.
这句话进入我们的脑海中。
But yet on Sundays, when the Lord's words come to our mind,
我爱主比这些更深吗
？Do I truly love the Lord more than these?
我爱主比跟朋友聊天更深吗
？Do I truly love the Lord more than having conversations with my friends?
我们相信我们立刻站起来。
I believe we can all arise.
我们会跟朋友说对不起。
We will tell our friends,
我现在需要去做礼拜。
Apologies, now it's time I need to go to church.
所以这句话是我们侍奉的那个动力。
So this is the dynamic, the motivation why we serve.
这句话是我们侍奉主的坚持。
So these are the words why we persevere.
今天我们常常听到要韧性。
Often we hear the term to be resilient.
韧性就是怎么咬都咬，怎么这个把它弯曲都没办法不会断的。
So resilient means you are unflappable. No matter how you are shaken, you are not shaken.
这个教会从创办到今天是101年。
So this year the church has been established for 101 years.
我相信今天的信徒已经来到了第四代了。
I believe the believers in this church have come to the fourth generation.
前代的弟兄姐妹怎么样把这个教会带下来
？How the former generations established and led the church till now？
从1923年刚刚建立的五人
，From 1923, the five charter members。
当然不是在这个地方
，Of course they are no longer here。
是租一个民宅，租一个人家的这个房子，居住的房子。
They started in a home residence。
五个人开始。
The five charter members
在如切的地方
，They were started in 如切，
离开我们这边大概5-6公里吧。
So apart from our place here，
六七八公里
，from Changi 6-7 kilometers away，
就在那个地方。
And they were there， started
慢慢就开始了。
They started Zion
Church。怎么有这个韧性
？Now what gave them such resilience？
这么坚持
？To persevere。
当中碰到很多的困难。
Of course they met with many problems。
第一个困难的话
，The first problem，
福音很难传。
The gospel so difficult to preach。
所以办学校。
So they started the school。
所以整个关注，整个注意力就放在学校。
So they paid attention to the building of the school。
福音很难传，慢慢的就不传福音了。
So because preaching the gospel is so difficult, then they stop preaching。
学校做得很大，很有名。
But they paid so much attention that the school become well known in Singapore。But thank God，
有弟兄姐妹有这种释放的韧性。
But brothers and sisters at that time they were resilient in preaching the word。
教会不能够变成学校。
They know the church cannot be a school。
学校可以帮助教会。
Even though the school can help the church。
但是学校不是我们关注的工作。
But the school cannot be the focus of our service。
办学校比爱主更深吗
？Do we love the school more than the Lord？
当我们想到这句话的时候
，When did we learn about these things？
不行。
We know,
我们要专注来侍奉教会。
They need to refocus to the church again.
对，工作非常困难。
So they met with problems.
后来就来到了第二次世界大战。
And then we know World War II came to Singapore.
大家都知道新加坡沦陷了。
And we know that Singapore was occupied.
新加坡被日本人占领了。
They were occupied by the Japanese.
而且所在日本人所占领的地方
，and the places where the Japanese occupied。
我们听过南京大屠杀
，we heard about the 南京 massacre。
我们像新加坡也有大屠杀
，there were also massacres even in Singapore。
新加坡的义勇军抵抗日本人
，because the Singapore Resistance Army resisted the Japanese。
华人的义勇军抵抗日本人
，the Chinese Resistance Troops resisted the Japanese。
新加坡的时候
，so when the Japanese occupied Singapore，
英国人还没有打就逃了。
The British without fighting they left。
英国的殖民地，新加坡是英国殖民地。
Now Singapore was once a British colonial。
英国人根本没有打就投降了。
So the British didn't even fight; they surrendered。
日本人来占领。
So Japanese occupied Singapore。
所以 杀了几万的华人。
And they killed tens of thousands of Chinese.
新加坡这么小小的一个地方,
such a small place in Singapore.
中国人很多，南京大屠杀死很多人。
南京 massacre in millions.
但是比较那个比例呢?
But if you were to compare,
新加坡死的人是比例上是比南京大屠杀还厉害。
By ratio, actually Singapore died more than the massacre in Nanking.
等到日本人退去之后,
so when the Japanese receded,
三年多,
and then for 3 odd years,
教会停摆,
so the church stopped or serving in the occupation.
教会怎么继续接下去啊?
But how to continue after the surrender?
有一代的信徒, 那一代的信徒,
and that generation of believers,
不是我们,
not us,
与那一代的信徒已经回到天家了,
because today that generation has been called home to the Lord.
他们知道,
but they knew.
他们必须爱主,
they need to love the Lord.
他们, 主耶稣问, 你爱我比这些更深吗?
Because they also have heard Jesus saying to them, do you love me more than
this?
Because post-war, everybody is developing,
发展自己的事业,
developing their careers,
发展自己的家庭,
developing their families.
但是有一些人, 听到了, 你爱我比这些更深吗?
But there were some in that generation, they heard, do you love me more than this?
他们起来让教会继续的运作。
They arose to continue the church.
然后到了教会曾经一段时间分裂了。
And the church was once divided.
有一部分弟兄姐妹离开了。
Some brothers and sisters, they left the church.
所以剩下的没有到大概一百人吧。
The rest, only 100 odd were left.
教会经过了这些困难。
So the church gone through all these diversities.
有弟兄姐妹 知道我们必须爱主,
but in such adversity, brothers and sisters knew they need to love the Lord. They persevered on.
一直发展到今天,
all the way till today.
感谢上帝,
we thank and praise God.
我今天讲的时候, 中国的这些同工们可能, 生疏,
now, when I say these things, maybe our fellow co-workers from China may find this unfamiliar.
明天上课的时候我们会送你一本西安堂的这个 百年的文献。
Now tomorrow, the first day of your class, now we will give you a gift of the publications of our Zion Church in our 100th anniversary.
你就会知道这个教会一代一代都有人知道我们必须爱主，我们爱主比我们主所给我们的各种的恩典更重要。
Then you will learn in our 100th years anniversary, there are generations of believers who believe that we should love the Lord more than these things.
这句话是侍奉主的动力,
this is the motivation why we serve.
这句话是侍奉主的坚持,
these verses make us persevere.
这句话也是侍奉主的提醒,
this verse is also a reminder why we serve.
我们有时候一时兴奋, 因为某一件工作, 因为开一个培灵会,
sometimes because a new work has started, we are enthusiastic.
那么一个培灵会来, 我们兴奋的复兴了。
A revival rally has come, we are enthusiastic through the rally.
但是不久就忘记了。
But after that, we forgot the enthusiasm.
不久我们或者奉献一些事情, 我们灰心丧志了。
Or maybe we meet with some difficulties in life, we lost hope in serving.
我们需要提醒。
But we remind us.
当我们退去的时候,
because the moment that we step
back,
when we start to do our own things,
事业成功了,
we may be successful in
赚钱了,
career, we may be making big money.
这句话就进入我们的脑中,
it is at this time the words of these came to us.
我爱主比这些更深吗?
These words from Jesus, do you love me more than these?
我相信当我们向彼得回答说是的我爱,
I believe we will respond like Peter, yes Lord, you know.
我们立刻得到提醒,
reminded again.
我们必须回来继续奔跑这条前面我们要走的这条侍奉的路。
We need to come back to the ministry to continue this life of ministry.
这句话也在生活上帮助我们。
So these words also help us in our daily life.
你看, 彼得成功了, 打了一网的鱼。
For example, look at Peter. He was so successful in fishing.
问彼得你爱我比这些鱼更深吗?
Again, it is at this time that Jesus asked Peter, do you love me more than all these fish?
彼得是加利利海最出色的渔夫。
Peter was a renowned fisherman at Galilee.
在前一次圣经记录的捕鱼, 彼得对主耶稣说, 今晚, 我们现在回来打鱼了, 我们打不着什么，今天没有鱼了。
Now previously, Peter once said to Jesus that all night long we have fish, but we caught nothing.
因为今天的潮流，今天的天气。
Maybe because of climate, maybe because of the tide.
原圣经没有这么记录。
Of course, the Bible didn't record these things.
当时。
But we were thinking.
彼得洗网回来洗网了。
When Peter came back to wash his nets.
耶稣说把船开。把船开到水深之处。
And Jesus told Peter to bring your boat afar.
彼得就讲这句话了。
And Peter said to Jesus.
啊，可见彼得当时知道没有鱼了。
Showed that Peter knew no more fish at this time.
但是耶稣的带领以后就不一样了。
Under the leading of Jesus, we know things have changed.
所以他是很有学识的，很有经验的，在捕鱼这方面。
So therefore, Peter was a professional. He was well schooled in fishing. 你爱我比这些更深
吗？
But Jesus now asked him, "You love me more than this?"
很多时候，我们的家庭、我们的孩子，上帝给我们。
So many times, God gifted us with careers, our families, children. God gave us children.
我们用整个时间关注。
We devote our time to our children.
请不要误会。
Nothing wrong. Please don't get me wrong.
关注他的家庭，关注的孩子是没有错的。
A man who devotes his life to his family, his children, nothing wrong.
当他关注到一个程度的时候
，But upon such a devotion,
耶稣说：“你爱我比这些更深吗
？”The words of Jesus will come to mind. Do you love me more than this?
或者我们自己问我：“爱这个孩子比主更深吗
？”Or sometimes we need to remind ourselves, Do I love my child more than Jesus?
如果试着这样
，If it is like that, if we do,
我们必须要被提醒、调整。我们的这一个爱
，Then we must be reminded again, readjust whom should we love.
很多
many things.
我们的打扮，我们的装饰
，even how we appear before people.
我们请一个有一个请一个来帮助司琴。
There was once we had someone to help us in to be a pianist.
每一次他司琴的时候，他都穿得很整齐，他里面已经穿得整齐了，他还要穿一个外套。
I remember that pianist when he came to serve, he was well dressed and even wear a coat.
天气很热，
I told
外套脱下来就可以了。
I told him that our weather is hot, just we don't need to wear that jacket.
他说不要，我穿。
And he told us, no, I'm going to wear. Every time he does that.
后来同工跟他比较熟了。
And some coworkers knew him better.
他就说。
And he said to us.
他说。
He said,
我当时比较年轻。
At that time, I was younger.
少不更事，少年人不大懂事。
So I was young, immature.
我在这里有刺青。
So I had a tattoo in my youth.
我在这里有刺青。
I had a tattoo in my youth.
我知道我来到教会。
But I know I come to church.
我要司琴。
I'm going to be a pianist.
这个不好。
This is not good.
我在坚持穿外套盖住这个。
So I insist wearing a jacket to cover that.
我听了很感动。
I was moved when I heard.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹。
So dear brethren.
当然，你们今天我们不会，你刺青你就下地狱了。没有，当然我不会这么说。
Of course, I'm not going to say to you, you have a tattoo, you're going to hell.
你刺青能，你仍然可以侍奉，可以爱主。
You have tattoos, you still can serve the Lord, you can still love God.
但是问题是
，But the problem is,
为什么你要刺青
？Why do you go tattoo in the first place?
你如果从圣经来看
，If you look from the Bible,
这个刺青是起源于一对异教的这个信仰。
So tattooing.Comes from a pagan faith.
所以，它当然发展到今天，它可能跟异教没有关系的。
Of course, now it may develop, and nobody thinks about that.
But why do you want to tattoo?
But why do you tattoo in the first place?
所以，当你要想要刺青的时候
，So before you even go to a tattooist,
你说很美啊。
You may say it looks good on me.
挂一个十字架可以刺激我爱主。
I put a cross here to remind me to love God.
可以激励我爱主。
To motivate me to love God.
我们爱主如果靠刺青来激励，我
看
这个信仰就差不多要完蛋了。
If you need a tattoo to remind you to love God more, something wrong with our faith.
我们的爱主是圣灵在里面给我们的一样的。
We love God. What is our motivation? The spirit within us.
当我们要做这些事情的时候
，So before we do these things,
我们问我们爱主比这些更深吗
？We need to ask, do we love the Lord more than this?
所以它是侍奉的动力。
So that is the dynamic of our
serving. 也是生活的动力跟提醒。
The dynamic and motivation and reminder why we live our life.
新加坡地很小。
Singapore land is scarce.
所以车很多。
So many much traffic.
所以车常常会碰到问题。
So cars often collide.
有时候车来到我们教会。
Or sometimes cars bring problems when they come to church.
我们最近教会改了。旁边不可以停车。
Now we make a traffic rule change.
为什么要这样
做？ No longer park where we used to.
为什么要这样做？
Why do we want to do that?
因为曾经有好几次，弟兄姐妹的车 相碰了。
So there were several incidents in church. Cars collided.
新加坡车很贵。
And in Singapore, cars are very expensive.
新加坡很多人爱车如命。
And a lot of people in Singapore love cars like their lives.
一点点撞到就一点点的踏到就受不了了。
A little scratch, a little collision, now they cannot stand it.
所以竟然两位信徒为着车吵架。
And there were some believers, they argue and quarrel over their cars.
其实这是不必要的。
Actually, this is unnecessary.
当这个事情要发生的时候呢
？So before such a thing actually happened,
一句话进入我们里面。
A lot of times, a verse may come to our mind.
我爱主比这些更深吗
？Do I love the Lord more than this?
我既是爱主的话
，If I truly love the Lord,
可以解决的。
And then,
我陪你吧。
And then, if this did happen,
我陪你吧。
Then sorry, I compensate
对不起，我陪你吧。
Or I'm sorry, I will compensate.
前不久我在我们训练百周年练诗的时候
，I still remember when our 100th anniversary choir was rehearsing.
我在外面，我因为执事的车停在外面。
So a deacon's car was parked outside the church.
怎么被我撞到了
？And I crashed it.
不知道是谁的车。
I did not know at that time whose car was that.
不知道是谁的车。
I did not know whose car was that.
所以我写一张字条在那边。
So I wrote a note on his car.
以后这个旁边有人说这车应该是去教会的人的，因为我们邻居没有这个车子。
And some passersby say that this car must belong to someone in church. We as neighbors or residents, we do not have this car.
所以我就回到教会来找了。
So I came back to church to look for the person.
真的是位执事的车。
And it belonged to a deacon of our church.
我对他说
，And I said to him,
我碰到你的车了。
I have collided
with
your car. Please go and fix it.
你去修理吧。
Please go and make repairs.
多少钱我都负责。
How much I will be responsible.
因为新加坡你也可以不必负责。
In Singapore, you do not need to pay full responsibility because we have insurance.
买保险的话，就由保险公司来承担。
So we are all insured. We let the insurance company take full responsibility.
但是如果说这个车是我赔得起的话，就我赔吧，不要去报，还要报保险公司，还有很多的手续。
But if I can afford to pay back this person, then we will take away the hassle of many paperwork.
结果他给我的电话是说，修理车要。一万多还是两万多块？新加坡钱。
And then he told me his car repairs amount to $20,000
Singapore. 这个是超过我所能力赔偿的。
Of course, this is beyond my ability to compensate.
我就对他说。
So I said to him,
那我们只好去报了。
Then let us file our claims.
当然我没有赔半分钱。
Of course, I didn't pay a single from the accident.
不过我的58%的那个折扣就不见了。
But my 50% 的 NCD,
我感谢上帝。
But I thank God.
我跟这位执事谈得非常好。
Then me and a deacon, we have a very cordial conversation.
对不起。
I keep saying to him, I'm sorry.
没有关系，没有关系。
And he keep telling me, doesn't matter, pastor, doesn't matter. Thank God.
我相信大家心里面都，我们的爱主是比这些更深的。
I believe when these things happen, both of us have an idea, we should love the Lord more than this.
所以我在这方面学到了功课了。
So from this incident, I learned a lesson.
你可以去看我的车。
Don't go and look at my car.
全身体无完肤啊，都是这边擦到那边这边撞到那边撞到。
My car is full of dents and scratches.
有时候我撞到人，有时候人撞到我。
Because sometimes I knock to someone's car, someone's car knocked onto me.
撞到人，我愿意赔。我如果赔得起。
If I can afford, I will compensate the person that I collided with.
撞到一点点呢
？If I'm collided by someone else.
通常我都说啊，算了。
Usually I'll say to the person, forget it.
我自己修理。
I will go and make my own repairs. But I don't.
因为它没有影响基建。
Because it doesn't affect my important things in the car.
它只是在这个外面这边一个洞，那边一个洞。
Only cosmetically, my car has a dent, has a scratch.
三十多年前。
30 odd years ago,
1980年代，40年前了。
Or rather 40 years ago in the 80s.
有一件事情我现在还记得。
There's one incident until now I still remember.In my van,
有一辆在泥土的罗里撞到我的后面。
So there was a
我车的后面。
There was a lorry that crashed into my boots.
所以停下来的时候，我的后面就有个洞了。
So when we stopped, there was a huge dent.
后来他问我怎么解决。
And he asked me how we're going to resolve this.
怎么解决
？So I asked him how are we going to resolve.
后来他就从他的袋里掏出$30。
And then from his wallet, he took out $30.
三十块钱是当时他一天的生活。
$30 was his day's wage.
结果我接受了。
and accepted.
当我开车走的时候
，and when I drove off，
半路的时候
，halfway，
我心里很不安。
My heart was not at peace。
其实我车可以走的。
Actually, my car can move。
只是不好看点，有个小小的凹洞。
Just like a bit ugly because a bit.
我为什么拿他30块钱
？And I was thinking to myself, why I still take $30 from him？
那三十块钱是他一天的生活。
$30 was his day's wage。
我还记得当时那一个人的脸。
I still remember the face of that man。
几十年前了。
That was 30 odd years ago.
这件事教训我。
But that incident taught me a lesson.
今天得饶人处且饶人。
Today it is better to forgive.
我们可以负担得起的。
If we can afford.
上帝给我们恩典可以负担得起的。
God has given us grace to afford.
我们不要计较。
Then let us not be petty.
我们爱主是比这些更深的。
Let us learn to love the Lord more than this.
这是生活上的一种的。这个激励跟提醒
This is the dynamic reminder how we should live our lives.
耶稣问他三次
The Lord Jesus asked Peter three times.
你爱我吗？你爱我吗
？Do you love me? Do you love me?
什么意思
？What does that mean?
因为我一生里面一直都会发生这些事情。
Because all our lives, these mishaps will happen.
我们都需要一直被提醒，一直被提醒。
Through these accidents, we must always be reminded.
我们爱主吗？我们爱主吗
？That despite of all this, do we love the Lord more?
彼得说爱
Of course, Peter did say he loves.
耶稣说你喂养我的羊
So Jesus says, now go and feed my sheep.
这句话什么意思啊
What does that mean?
当然对彼得来说他要牧养群羊
Of course, to Peter, it means he needs to go and shepherd the Lord's sheep. Because he will be the leader of the church.
对我们来说
But to us,
其实你喂养我的羊就是我们要成为一个有贡献的信徒
Feeding the sheep applied to us to be a contributing Christian.
对我们的家庭有贡献
We must contribute to our family.
对我们的社会有贡献
We must contribute to the society we live in.
对我们的教会更要有贡献
Even more, contribute to the church that we love.
我们爱主之后
If after we love the Lord,
耶稣说你喂养我的羊
Jesus said to you, feed my sheep.
弟兄姐妹
Brothers and sisters, it means
我们对教会有贡献吗
It means do we contribute to the church?
你的贡献就是我们不要停止聚会
Of course, the most basic contribution, do not stop meeting each other. Not just on Sunday worship.
可能的话
If we can,
参加我们的这个团契
Attend our fellowships.
参加我们的祷告会
Attend our prayer meetings.
参加我们的布道会或培灵会
Attend our gospel meetings or revival meetings.
这就是贡献了
This is contribution.
当然我们怎么样我们赚很多的钱
Of course, we also earn money.
今天整个社会呢
？The whole society.
新加坡是可以说是这个人均收入啊，我相信不是排第二，应该是前三名里面。我们的人均收入全世界200多个国家是第三名啊。
So therefore, our wage per capita compared to several countries around us.
人均收入是8万多美元吧
？It's $80,000 per
capita. 太有钱的社会了。
It is a very affluent society.
但是当然，我们弟兄姐妹是普通的。
But of course, brothers and sisters among us, we are ordinary.
绝对没有财主在这边。
Surely we have no tycoons among us.
财主是什么意思
？What is a rich tycoon?
福布斯杂志里面排有名的，
It means
有排名的。
If your name is in Forbes.You are that tycoon.
我相信我们没有。
None of us are here.
对不起，如果有的话，恐吓你告诉我。
My apologies. If you are among them, and I didn't,
我不知道。
I do not know.
但是我相信没有。
But I believe none.
我们是普通人。
We are ordinary.
然而神给我们有能力，也能够赚一点点的钱。
But when God gives us ability to earn some money,
你爱我比这些更深吗
？When the Lord asks us, "Do you love me more than these?"
当我们说主啊，我爱你。
When we respond, "Yes, Lord, I do,
I love
you." Then we have the strength.
当我们说主啊，我爱你。
When we say, "Lord, I love you,"
我们就有力量奉。
Then we have the ability to give.
你看西安堂奉献的那个报告。
When you see the offering reports of our church, we need to give thanks to God.
今天在西安堂以外
，today beyond Zion Church,
我们还有东甲的营地，很大的一个营地。
We also have a Tangka youth camp.
我们有西安楼5层的这个大楼。
We also have a 5-story 西安 house.
我们在马来西亚还有3个西安楼。
In Malaysia, we have 3 more similar 西安 house. And we have other mission chapels in Singapore.
我感谢上帝。
And for these things, we give thanks.
与许多弟兄姐妹爱主比主给我们的恩典更深。
These are the fruits.Of brothers and sisters obeying the verse, Lord, I love you more than this.
到了这个时候
at this time,
主耶稣就告诉彼得
Jesus now said to Peter,
他以后怎么样
What will happen to him?
他现在你年轻可以自由来往
Now you are young, you move freely.
但有一天人家带你到你不愿意去的地方
One day you'll be brought to places that you do not want to go. The Bible says,
耶稣说话是指着彼得要怎么样死，要怎么样荣耀上帝
The Bible says that Jesus said this to point out what kind of death Peter must go through. Jesus first told Peter,
你自由地来为主工作,
now you can freely serve the Lord.
但有一天你要被抓, 要被人钉十字架, 要死,
you'll be arrested and led to your death.
彼得有逃跑吗?
Did Peter run away?
没有逃跑,
he didn't.
他就在他释放之前知道他以后要为主殉道。
He already knew before he started his ministry, he will be martyred.
但是他没有逃跑。
But after that, he didn't run away.
为什么?
And why?
他爱主比他的自己的生命更深。
Because truly, he learned how to love the Lord more than his own life.
感谢上帝。
We thank God.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹,
so dear brethren,
让我们用主耶稣复活以后对彼得说的这句话,
let us remember the resurrected Lord saying to what Peter,
常常在我们的心里回想,
these words may it always be reminded to us.
当我们渐渐的冷淡的时候,
such that when one day we are cold to ministry,
当我们没有想奉献却没有能力奉献的时候,
when we have disobeyed the ability to offer,
当我们爱世界,
and when we find ourselves love the world more than the Lord, may these words remind us again, Lord, do I love these more than you? And our response should move us to serve, to be a resilient disciple. Our response will remind us to continue this blessed way, all the way till we see the Lord again. Let us pray. 天父, 我们要感谢, 赞美你。 主啊, 你的恩典, 实在是够我们用的。 你的平安, 是我们所需要的。 你的恩惠, 是我们要依靠的。 感谢主, 这么多丰丰富富的恩典, 你都白白地赐给我们。 我们没有办法赚取, 我们没有办法自己自得。 不过感谢主, 你爱我们。 你把你的生命赐给我们， 因此主啊， 让我们常常得到纪念， 得到提醒， 也让我们成为， 让这些话成为我们的动力， 使我们一旦遇见危险， 遇见困难， 遇见绝望的时候， 我们被提醒， 主爱我们， 主牺牲于我们， 让我们也愿意爱神， 比这一切还有更多， 加添我们力量， 使我们继续走这条属天的道路。 我们感谢赞美你，我们恭敬感恩祷告，奉主耶稣的名求，阿门。